And so, because the continental chefs in United's flight kitchens from Honolulu to New York are experts in the culinary arts rather than in words, they have set up a display as the personal expression of their mission, which is to see that all meals served on United are unsurpassed.
Eating is important. We all need to eat. But how did food make the transition from the kitchen into the air? The first recorded airline meal was served on a 1919 Handley Page transport flight from London to Paris. The cold box lunch included a sandwich and fruit and cost 3 shillings. In 1936, United Airlines installed mini kitchens, or galleys, into its fleet of airplanes to prepare simple hot meals for passengers. Other airlines instituted their own specialty meals. In 1946, Pan American Airways developed frozen meals in partitioned trays that could be heated while in flight. This concept inspired the TV dinner that became popular in the 1950s. From the 1950s to the mid-1970s, meals on airlines were luxurious, featuring menus created by world-famous chefs, served on fine china with white linen napkins and tablecloths. By the 1970s, passengers wanted lower fares, and in 1977, Southwest Airlines emerged, marketing itself as the Peanut Airline, offering rock-bottom ticket prices, but no perks. In other words, you can fly for peanuts, but the peanuts, well, that's your meal. Other airlines followed suit, reducing food choices on domestic flights in order to offer low-cost fares. Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.